اعلام همبستگی اعضای پارلمان اروپا با اعتصاب کنندگان در لیبرتی، لندن، برلین، ژنو، اتاوا و ملبورن برای آزادی هفت گروگان اشرفی.
Hello, I want to express to you as a member of the European Parliament my complete moral outrage at the massacre that occurred on the 1st of September in Camp Ashraf. For years people have been warning that such an attack would take place and sadly for years we ignored that advice. The reality is horrific. The deaths of ordinary men and women, young, old, some of them infirm, some of them destroyed in the hospital unit. But what we can do is make sure that such an atrocity never happens again. The seven hostages that are currently still being held, that the authorities, the Iraqi authorities, will still not be clear about, will still not admit that they hold. They must be returned to their families and their friends in Camp Liberty. If liberty is to mean anything. And therefore all of you, families, friends and supporters, who are making this amazing sacrifice of going on hunger strike, my thoughts and the thoughts of other parliamentarians are with you. Our solidarity is with you. And I give you this promise, because it's the promise that history has shown us, that in the end, you will win. That justice and decency and fairness will be yours to taste, to hold and to embrace amongst your families and your community. Thank you.
We are really very shocked, and we have been shocked till the day of the 1st September when the massacre in Camp Ashraf was reported to us. We couldn't believe here in the European Parliament that such a rude, crude, barbarous act against humanity is possible in the beginning of the 21st century. There are various deputies, representatives of the peoples of Europe, shouting, adding their voices to those who are protesting against this massacre, which took place against political prisoners in the Camp Ashraf. The only blame for which was that they were politically opposing to a regime. We have gathered in the last Strasbourg plenary meeting, several deputies from approximately all the parties, all the groups comprising the European Parliament, to add our voices, to stir up and to protect the seven abducted people from the Camp Ashraf, for whose future we are very concerned. We do demand the formation of an independent committee able to establish the facts and to protect the innocent people suffering from such rude exercises. We wish to tell to the Iranian people opposing to the regime that the European deputies, representatives, 500 million people of Europe will side with them in order that such occurrences as the massacre and the Ashraf camp will not be repeated and that the political liberties will be protected in every part of the world and in Iran in this particular case. We wish all to you courage, and you have to know that too many people are with you, trying to help you in your struggle for political liberty and democracy. Thank you.
Bonjour, Jean-Jacques Bissep, député européen, membre de la Commission des affaires étrangères et de la sous-commission des droits de l'homme. Je voudrais ici apporter mon soutien et dire ma plus ferme condamnation par rapport à ce qui s'est passé au camp d'Ashraf sur les réfugiés iraniens qui ont été victimes de l'armée irakienne et qui ont payé de leur vie leur velléité d'indépendance et de lutte pour liberté contre ce régime tyrannique qui, bien entendu, sévit en Iran. Je veux aussi dire que, tout comme la communauté internationale a condamné cette attaque dans un camp de réfugiés placé sous l'autorité, effectivement, des autorités internationales, donc des réfugiés qui sont protégés par les différentes conventions internationales, je réaffirme ma condamnation. Je veux apporter mon soutien notamment aux 7 otages qui ont été capturés lors de cette opération et qui sont aujourd'hui en grève de la faim. De par le monde, plusieurs Iraniens mènent aujourd'hui une grève de la faim en soutien de ces 7 otages. Je leur apporte aussi mon soutien et je leur dis de continuer ce combat parce que c'est un combat qui est juste. La communauté internationale ne doit pas les laisser tomber. Je ferai tout qui est en ma possession pour effectivement faire connaître leur situation au sein de l'Union européenne et au sein effectivement de différentes organisations à laquelle j'appartiens.